Hey everyone, Grant K for the Flame Learning channel. In this video, we'll look at the various elements related to the tangent panels in the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products. Now typically, the Wacom pen and tablet is great for most of your work. But for some tasks like color grading, using a dedicated surface control is better since you can modify multiple controls at the same time. The Flame products already supported the tangent element panels, and with Flame 2017 Extension 1, there is new added functionality. Firstly, the tangent element panels are supported in all the Flame products on both Linux and macOS. Previously, only the Linux users had access to these panels. Secondly, we have updated to the latest TangentHub software version 1.3.1, so new capabilities are available. This new version of TangentHub is automatically installed with all Linux-based Flame products. On macOS, you need to download the TangentHub application from the Tangent website at www.tangentwave.co.uk. When installed, you have access to the applications and the documentation. The Linux install path is /opt/tangent, and for macOS, just look in the Applications Tangent folder. The latest version of the Tangent Hub adds the following features. Firstly, there is support for the Tangent Ripple. The Ripple is an affordable 3-ball panel with a small form factor. This is a great companion for a MacBook Pro for onset work or for suites that might not need all the capabilities of the Element panels. Next, there is support for the Tangent Element VS. Tangent Element VS is a software panel emulator that can run on an iPad or an Android tablet. The emulator allows you to control the Flame products over a Wi-Fi network. You can select any of the various element panels, like the trackable, the multifunction, the knob or the button panel, and control the applications. It is also possible to use more than one tablet, so you could create a surface control with virtual panels. Demo versions are available on the Apple App Store and on Google Play. Note that you need a large tablet to accommodate the display. Devices like the iPad Mini or smaller will not be large enough to display the panel interface. The next feature is functions remapping. This has been a long-standing request from many users who want to be able to customize the controls of the element panels. This includes a new graphical user interface mapping application that allows you to change the assignment of application functions on the various panels. So let's give this a try. The remapping function is designed to be easy to use. We'll start with a sequence that contains segments, and we'll add a color corrector timeline effects. From there, we'll explore the mapper. The configuration of the mapping is saved with the OS user. So if you log into the application on Linux, or as your own user account on macOS, you'll be able to customize the panel's mapping on an application's basis. To start the mapper, it varies depending on the OS. So for Linux, open a shell and navigate to the /opt/tangent/bin and type /tangent mapper. For macOS, you click the Applications folder, choose Tangent, and select the Tangent Mapper. The mapper shows the various panels. If you run multiple applications at the same time, like using the color correct workflow with Flame and Lustre for instance, you can select which application you want to remap by selecting it in the mapper. Talking about the connected color workflow, the tangent panels are now automatically switched when alt-tabbing between Flame and Lustre. Now in the mapper application, you can select various panels. Note that the Flame products support the Ripple in Element TK emulation mode. You can also select the various panels and see the current mapping. And you can select Jump to Current Mode to show the current area of the application. So it's quite easy to remap controls, modify the control behavior, and even rename the display on the panel. Let's give it a try by adding a CC timeline effects on a segment and see how to modify the mapping. For the first example, we'll change the mapping of the master RGB offset control of the CC editor. Select the CC master tab in the mapper and then select the element TK panel. If you click on the master RGB offset, a menu appears and gives you various options. Firstly, we'll change the controls of the left ring. If you click on the master RGB offset button, a list of mappable options are presented. They are organized by sections. Color correct represents all the controls located inside the CC timeline effects editor. The color correct editor represents the many editor controls. There is also the color warper editor, transport, and finally the fake key press, which we'll see later. Now we want to change this offset and map it to the blue offset. Follow the color correct editor navigation menu and select the blue offset. As you can see, when a new control is selected, the display on the control panel is automatically selected. If you switch to flame and play with the left ring, you will see that the left ring is now assigned to the blue offset. So that was easy. Now we want to customize what is displayed on the panel for the blue offset control. Click on the blue offset button in the mapper, and in the floating window, type a new name in the display field text box. The display is now updated. As you can see, my B offset control moves the blue offset channel, but it's not fast enough. So you can change the sensitivity of the control through the mapper. If we go back to the mapper and open the control mapping, you can see the sensitivity control in the window. Deselect global and then move the cursor from fine to coarse. Now let's change the blue offset using the left ring. As you can see, the value updates quite fast. From looking at the control mapping window on the right side, there is an alternate mapping. This control is available when you hold the B key on the panel. That provides double controls on the same panel, and you can use the mapper to configure the controls. Now, when you are happy with your mapping, you should save your work. From the file menu on the mapper, select Save, and you can then rename your mapping. A mapper XML file is saved to your Linux or macOS home user account. If you log off and return later with the same user account, all your mapping files will be available. Note that if you change your user account, you could copy the Tangent folder and files into the other account, and this will give you access to the mapping you had previously created. Now we'll use an advanced technique to map a control available in the application to the control panel. To do so, we will use Flame's shortcut editor. As an example, we'll map the Add Video Track control in Flame to a button on the panel. In the shortcut editor, locate the new video track function. On the mapper, select the Timeline tab and press the B button. We'll assign the Add Video Track to this button. Press the Mapping button and select the Fake Key Press. In the Key Press settings, press Ctrl-Shift-Tab. Next, press the B button on the panel, and a new video track is added to the current sequence. So that's how you can modify mapping using the Tangent panel. Please refer to the Tangent Mapper documentation for more details. Now the mapping workflow in Lustre is similar to the one you've just seen in Flame. If you start Lustre, the mapper shows Lustre in the Select Application menu. You can then easily navigate between the applications to see and edit the mapping. Finally, The Tangent Element VS is a handy way to add surface control capabilities to your suite, even if it is a mobile laptop configuration, or to add extra panels. The Tangent Element VS can also be used to learn the various mapping of flame and luster on the element. In my example, I will use a ripple panel for three-ball grading, since having a tactile experience is important for grading, and I will use multiple tablets to emulate buttons, knobs, and wheels. The first thing you need to do is install the Tangent Element VS application. It is available on the Apple App Store and Google Play. For this example, we will use three iPads. Please be aware that the iPad Mini is too small, but regular iPads, including iPad version 1 and iPad Pro, are supported. From the App Store, we'll download and install the Tangent Element VS. When installed, run the application. Note that if you download the demo version, you are limited to 60 minutes per day. The Tangent Element VS connects to the Tangent Hub running on your workstation over the Wi-Fi network. On my Linux workstation, I've used one of my available network connections to add a Wi-Fi router and configured a Wi-Fi network. Connect the tablet to the Wi-Fi network. When all of this is done, we are ready to pair the Tangent Element VS to the Tangent Hub. In the mapper, go to the File menu and locate the panel configuration. In the Wi-Fi pairing for Element VS, press Enable Pairing Mode. Automatically, the tablet and the hub should see each other, and then you're able to start using the tablet to emulate one of the Tangent Element panels. Alternatively, you can add multiple tablets and define an element panel per tablet. The Tangent Element VS can also be remapped in the same way as the elements seen earlier in this video. The interaction over Wi-Fi is smooth and there is no lag, so performing grading or any VFX with a mixture of panels and tablets should be quite effective. So with the updates to Flame 2017 Extension 1, as well as the Tangent Hub software, the functionality and flexibility of working with the Tangent panels has been greatly enhanced. The ability to remap controls, as well as add extra panels running on tablet devices, will definitely open some creative workflows. Be sure to check out the other features, workflows, and updates to the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.